So today I thought I would take you through my garden really quickly and show you how things turned out. I've been experimenting with different ways to grow. I would eventually like to have just kind of like raised beds in here, but it's really expensive to make, you know, nice ones, the wood, you know, and then I want to put hardware cloth on the bottom. And so I'm eventually going to move everything over to raised beds. But this year I experimented with some straw bale gardening, and so I thought I'd just take you through real quick and show you how things did. And this garden is like kind of located to the north of our home. It actually does get some good sun. There is Moscow Mountain in the background there, so the sun comes up over in that area and gets some good morning sun. This area is shaded right now, and here's a project over here. I have two projects over here. We'll talk about them another day. But here's a pallet garden, and I really, really, really liked it. I'm going to get some lettuces that I'm going to seed now. I have some celery that I planted here, but I've never grown celery before, so that's something new I'm trying. And in the middle where there's a hole, there was this insanely big cabbage, and actually I just finished eating it yesterday. The only problem I had was like these two empty rows. I tried repeatedly to plant some beets. I think it would be too shallow for the beets, so I just wanted to try it. And some radishes. Radishes do fine in here. But the slugs just kept eating them off, you know, before they could get established. So I'm gonna have to figure out something different for that. So next, as you come in, is the six stock tanks that I've kind of converted over to raised beds. And this has a broccoli plant that I let go to seed. So we'll see how that does. Just some lettuces and carrots and kale. This one mostly just has beets in it, and you can't see them, but I have some little tiny seedlings in there in the empty spaces. This one has, this is spinach that I'm trying to get growing for the winter, for the fall. And then these, my Egyptian bunching onions, which will grow, or walking onions. They'll grow a little bulblet at the top, and then it'll bend over and plant itself, and they spread that way. I've got four plants. I bought these last fall, and so they're really doing well. I'm happy about that. Some dill and a cabbage. I'm sorry about the lighting. There's the sun nice and bright this morning. Then I'm trying to get some lettuce going. Same over here. I planted some arugula, but I don't know. I think some flea beetles or something are getting it. So I'm going to have to look about. I know there's something you can make and spray on them. There's a nice cabbage I'm going to be harvesting soon. And in here, I had some onions. They are really struggling because I put a couple cabbages in here. This red one is going to be nice when it gets growing, but this kale in the middle just took over, and I think I'm just going to end up pulling it out. It's just so big now, it's can't even do anything with it. So, and I'm going to plant some more kale here. I got to hurry up and do that before it gets too cool. So now this part is kind of more of the straw bale gardening, and this potato row did really well, but I will be honest, I planted them three times before I got them to take off. And so at first I thought like this is the worst thing ever, but now I just love it. And because I just come out and like, look, I'm halfway through a bale here, and you can just pull it apart and the potatoes just fall out. I mean, there's no digging at all. These are some I just pulled out yesterday. So I'm totally sold. I think that the straw bales are the best way to grow potatoes. Other things I had mixed feelings about, but this is kind of hard to see. I had this crib here because I have a vine growing on the one side, but I didn't get it, I did not get it really staked down very well. So I have two things in here. There's onions, which are growing really well. And then this viney stuff is called Malabar spinach. I also have some over here. So it's supposed to be a heat tolerant, you know, a green that you eat in the summertime. And it's a vine. It's doing really well over on this part of the trellis. I have a ladder here that I'm growing up. So the idea is you can just pick the leaves off to eat, and then it'll just grow more leaves all summer. So, but it's a heat loving plant, so it didn't really take off until, you know, maybe about 3 weeks ago, but it's doing really well now. Here, I'm gonna move out of the way. Here's my blueberry beds, raised beds. I have 8 blueberries planted here. Right beside them, I put up a fence, and I'm trying to start some peas. And there's some radishes in front. And so for a fall garden. So we'll see if they make it. I'm not sure. Just giving it a try. And I tried to plant some carrots too, but they don't seem to be doing anything at all. But sometimes they take a little bit longer to get going. Here's my sweet potato tire, and they look like they're doing well. So we'll see if what kind of sweet potatoes we actually are able to get out of there in a couple of months, I guess, in a month or two. Okay, now these bales have a variety of things planted in them. Here's a pepper plant, obviously. There's an eggplant, which has not done anything yet. More peppers, basil, and then I have some beets, and this is my project for today, is trying to do something with these beets because I'm going to pull one out. I think they're getting humongous. Oh yeah. Holy cow. That was like the biggest beet I've ever seen. Okay. So I definitely have to do something with the beets today. But I have some good ideas. So make some pickled beets. Try some kvass. Here's some more pallets that I put green beans in. And they seem to be doing really well. And need to pick those as well. More bales with beets, cauliflower, broccoli, the bugs don't get it all. More peppers, trying to speed this up a little bit. More peppers, eggplants. They're starting to really take off now. This is a ground cherry. I heard so many great things about the ground cherry and how fun it is and it's prolific. That thing about died. First of all, I planted like 25 seeds, only got one plant to go, and then it about died. It looked so sickly for so long. It's just now starting to take off. So I hope we get some ground cherries. Here's a kale. These are jalapenos. And then we have the tomatoes, which, okay, so good and bad. The trellis is really hurting because they fell over. There are so many tomatoes. I mean, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get it. I mean, there's just so many tomatoes in here. It's hard to get it, especially that it just fell over from all the wheat. So I'm gonna have to. I do like, they're growing in the straw bales. I think it was a good way to grow them, and got some red ones coming. So, but I'm just gonna have to make a lot better trellis next year. Nah. Cause it's gonna be, and some of these, I mean, they're just huge. Like this is a sauce tomato. I mean, it's just humongous. And they're all in there. Yeah, there's just so many. So I'm gonna have a good crop of tomatoes, hopefully. And then along this back, the asparagus. Let's see if I can get it in this way. The asparagus. Raised bed with the strawberries planted in the middle. So down the middle of each bed. You hear a little quiver over there. Then I have some corn, which is looking pretty decent now. It was really struggled for a while. And I have a totally different spot where I'm going to expand my garden and put corn next year. So it's not always going to be kind of in the middle of my garden here. But this year had open space, so I just went for it. And then the cucurbits. So they are all doing well. So I have 15 different varieties here. I'll try to point out a few of them. This is a patty pan. This is Henry's favorite little yellow squash. Sometimes I see them called scallop squash. Just like it's a summer squash. Just like to saute it in butter and eat it. I grew something called a sunshine. It's a winter squash. This one here. And you can use it, you know, use it to make pies and stuff. What else is here? There's a buttercup squash. A buttercup squash in here. I know that there's supposed to be some butternut. I'm gonna look on the other side. They really, really, really been very prolific. I think I saw some over here. There's some butternut squashes. Holy cow, I can't even walk through here now. Okay, here's a called a delicata, or sweet potato squash. One of my favorites. I think I'm gonna pick that one. Behind me I have spaghetti squash, which has gone completely crazy. And I thought I bought like a mini spaghetti squash, but there's no way because these are like definitely full-size spaghetti squashes. And there's like about a dozen on there. This is where my pickling cucumber was supposed to be, and it just did not grow. Then the next bale I have, it's hard to see, the sour gherkin. They have, like, the little cucumbers that look like watermelons, but I haven't actually been able to harvest any. But there's like little tiny ones on here, so hopefully they'll be coming soon. And this is just called a munchin cucumber, so it's starting to trellis and grow. This is supposed to be a cantaloupe. I'm not sure what it's growing. It's been really slow, but it's growing. Zucchini, which of course is completely out of hand, and we've had many zucchinis already. This is called a vine peach. I'll be honest, I don't know what it is. Puts a fruit on and looks like kind of like similar to a cantaloupe. It's came free with some seed that I bought. I think this is just a small pumpkin. What was supposed to be there was a different kind of cucumber that didn't make it. And then up here I have three things growing. So this was supposed to be, I don't know if you can see that one very well. It's supposed to be a Seminole pumpkin, but I think it's Crenshaw pumpkin. These are like heritage varieties. That's definitely not what it's supposed to look like, what I thought I had planted there. So I've got to contact the company about that. Then I have some Blue Stella right there. So it just kind of stays that bluish green color, but it's supposed to be a really good keeper. And lastly, I just show you, I have some of these, they're called Pepito. And you grow them for the seeds. You grow them for the pumpkin seeds. So you don't really eat the orange flesh. It's not that tasty or good. Supposedly, you just actually just grow them for their hullless seeds. So they're just the green seeds inside. So that's something new I'm trying. And there's like about, there's many, many on there. Oh, look at this little guy. I don't know if I can get him. He's totally covered in pollen. He's like yellow with pollen. There he is. Oh yeah. He's trying to wash himself off. So that's it. That's the garden in a nutshell. I tried to make it quick. But I just wanted to share what I had growing in here.